Have you ever had to remotely SSH into one of your EC2 servers to manage your AWS account? Have you ever tried to use the AWS command line interface to make a repetitive change, to extract information from a report, or to make a quick configuration edit? Setting up an environment to use AWS command line tools can take a lot of time, and you may even have to spend money running a Linux virtual machine just so you have a shell to run all of those tools. Well, AWS have made this process considerably easier with AWS CloudShell. AWS CloudShell is a browser-based shell which makes managing your AWS environment through the command line an absolute breeze. This is useful because no matter where you are or what computer you're logged into your AWS console from, you will get a consistent shell which allows you to securely manage your AWS account. And the shell comes with a lot of really useful tools too, the most powerful of all being the AWS command line interface, or the CLI. In this ACG Fundamental, we're going to see how easy it is to start using CloudShell. We'll see what tools it provides, like the AWS command line interface, and we'll see how easily configurable it is by installing some shell customizations. And best of all, it's completely free and available right now in these AWS regions. Let's dive in. Okay, here I am in my AWS console, and you might not even notice it, but here in the top corner is a button which will launch AWS CloudShell. Let's click it and see what happens. Okay, welcome to CloudShell. Don't show this again, but it just mentions we have some pre-installed tools, we've got included storage, and we can save our files and settings in our home directory. Let's click close. This can take up to a minute or two to launch, so be patient and we'll be ready to go. Okay, preparing terminal, and here we go. So now we have a command line that we can use. This is it, this is CloudShell. From here, we have full access to our AWS account, and we don't even have to configure any keys or credentials. You will automatically assume a role based on your IAM identity. Let's see what tools are available by default. Okay, first thing on your list is the AWS command line interface. Excellent. Looking further down, there's the Elastic Beanstalk command line interface, the Elastic Container command line, there's Flask, there's SAM, which is Serverless Application Manager, and if the tool you want isn't here, you can even install your own. CloudShell provides you with 1 GB of home directory space, which is persistent. That's right, whenever you launch CloudShell, you will get access to the same 1 GB of storage. So you can install whatever tools you need to operate in your AWS account, and they will always be there. Let's take a quick look at the Actions menu up in the top right. We have a way to launch a new tab, just in case you need to be typing in one window and looking at logs in another window. You can have two of them running at the same time. And we're also able to download files from the shell or upload files to the shell. And you can even restart or delete the entire home directory if you've broken something and you want to reset it back to what it's like when you first launched it. All right, let's go through a quick demo. Firstly, let's try the AWS command. I'm going to list all my EC2 instances. Let's see if I have any in this account. So AWS EC2 describe instances. And you can see we instantly are able to see what EC2 instances are running via our command line interface without having to configure the command line interface, which is awesome. It makes it so easy to use. Now, let's go through a quick demo. Say you would like to install the AWS Cloud Development Kit and then initialize a new cloud application using it. First, we can install the AWS CDK with the npm command sudo npm install -g for global so everyone can use it, and then AWS CDK. And that will go off, use the npm command to download and install it into our CloudShell. Excellent. Now we need to create a directory, make the CDK, let's go into that directory, and we're going to CDK init app language, and I'll choose Python. And it's that simple. We didn't need an EC2 instance. We didn't need a local shell with credentials configured and SSH keys downloaded. One click and two commands gives you an AWS CDK project ready to be developed. If you also prefer a different shell, or you want to reconfigure your default bash environment to something more functional for you, because you have that local disk space to work with, you are free to do whatever you'd like. Let's install an open source bash framework called omybash. And I'm going to paste this command in. And that was pretty simple and it took about 1 second. You can see we now have a simple, pretty themable, customizable bash shell in our CloudShell. It's pretty easy to see with my two examples that your options are pretty much limitless when using AWS CloudShell. Well, limitless up to 1 GB of storage. You can install what you need, you can interact with any AWS service that the AWS command line interface gives you access to, and you can do it from anywhere as long as you're able to log in to your AWS account and click that CloudShell button. Thank you for watching, keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus, and we'll see you next time.